Hey guys, welcome to my channel. So today's video is going to be about newspapers, and I know that you guys might think, who read newspapers in 2021? Well, I do, because I have to. Because in India, to get local news, we have to rely on newspaper. There is no alternative of that. There is no service which provide news about your city. So yeah, I can get international and national news by browsing web, but to know about something happened in my neighborhood, I still have to rely on local newspapers. Now, I don't read newspaper all the time. I just read when I have to, like something happened in my college or somewhere, so I expect some news. Only that time I read newspapers. So buying newspaper is stupid for me. So that's why I prefer e-paper, and here's the website of one of the most popular newspaper service here in India, which is Amar Ujala. And if you guys don't know Hindi, Amar means immortal, Ujala means light, but I don't think this needs a translation. So yeah, this is the e-paper. I grew up reading this newspaper, and here's the cities, and I can select any city. So here's my city, Bareilly city. If I choose this, I think I will get newspaper of my local. So here's the newspaper of my city. But the issue I got with this thing is, if I try to go to next page, it's going to ask for a login, and if I make account and login, it's going to ask for a subscription. You can read here, yearly subscription, asking for some money, and I don't want to pay them. Now the reason why I don't want to pay is pretty simple, that nobody likes losing money. But I'm going to satisfy myself by saying that there, half of the newspaper is filled with ads and half with paid news. Also, it's e-paper, so there is no manufacturing cost. Why they are asking money for this? So yeah, I cannot get the access of this newspaper, because the developer of this website worked really hard to do not let anyone see the second page of this newspaper without the subscription and the account. But for me, I think the first page is enough, because now what I can do is I can press right and view image this, and in the URL, if I change this 1 to 2 and press enter, so here's the second page. So by changing this number here, I can get any page. Like I want third page, just write 3 here. And you can also see the date here in the URL. So by changing this URL, like if I want 9 January newspaper, I can change this date to 9 January, and I can get the newspaper of 9 January, page number 3. And by the way guys, this is the website of one of the best Hindi newspaper in India. So now what I can do is I can use wget inside a for loop to get all the images of my newspaper. Here is this very simple for loop, which is printing digits from 1 to 20. So here's the digit, but there is an issue with this, that the single digit does not contain 0 first, and here in URL the single digit contains 0 first. So to fix this, what I can do is I can first write 0 here, and then instead of 20, let me just print this to 9, and then there is another array which is printing from 10 to 20. Let's change it to 22 and press enter. So this problem is fixed now. So by using this trick, I wrote this simple bash script which is running the loop which I just told you, and it's using wget inside, and I'm using this minus nc flag, and it's very important, because what this flag is doing is it's ignoring the download if a file already exists. So suppose I run this script, it's going to download the newspaper for me, and if I run this script again, it's not going to re-download the entire newspaper again. It's just going to ignore the download and open my already existing newspaper. Also, I'm using minus o flag here to give the output. I created a e-paper directory where I keep all my newspapers. The file name will be similar to the page number name. I will show you this later. Here on line 5, I'm getting the date by using date command in the exact format this URL need, and I'm plugging this value here on the URL, and I'm only creating this date variable when user provide nothing. So you can also provide a particular date and get e-paper of that particular date. In last, I'm just sending a notification and using sxiv with minus c for zoom to open all my pages. So let me just quickly run this e-paper script and show you my way of downloading the newspaper. And if I press enter, it's going to download the pages. So the for loop is running and it will take around 20 to 30 seconds. And one more thing, it's only going to happen once, because once I get all my pages locally, that minus NC flag will ignore the download. So here I got my notification and my sxiv is showing all the pages. Also, I was using minus Z flag, so it's zoomed in, which is pretty good because now I can read the text properly. And if I press N, here's the next page, and here's the next page. And I think this is very cool. By using this, I can just get my newspaper instantly and read anything whatever I want, and I like this. So yeah, this is pretty cool. Now let me just quickly show you where the download happened. So I have this e-paper folder in my computer, and here inside this date directory, and this is just a directory with date on it, here's the download happened. And also here 12.jpg means this is the 12th page of 13th January 2021 newspaper. So I can use rsync to sync it with my web or anywhere, so I can read newspaper anywhere. But I don't think I will make the link public, because this way they can sue me for this, and I want to get sued by Mark Zuckerberg and Jeff Bezos, not Amar Ujala. You love.